Pues difícilmente lo podríamos saber, tristes, porque se ha producido una de esas cosas que yo creo que no suelen pasar en la vida.
In 2015, Real Madrid committed one of the biggest blunders in their history. A major slip-up which will go down in the club's history. It's time to look back at some crazy forfeited matches. In December 2015, Real Madrid took on Cadiz in the last 16 of the Copa del Rey. Madrid easily won, notably with a goal from Denis Cheryshev. The problem? The Russian was suspended for this match after receiving too many yellow cards the season before with Villarreal.
Pero es que, sinceramente, es que si el jugador no nos lo ha dicho, que es el que lo tiene que saber. Si no nos lo ha dicho la Federación y no nos lo ha dicho el Villarreal, que también lo conoce, es imposible que lo supiéramos.
Florentino Pérez may have blamed other people, but didn't appeal the outcome. A 3-0 defeat by forfeit. Disqualified from the competition. The worst thing is, Real Madrid noticed the mistake during the match. Cheryshev was replaced at halftime, and the Cadiz fans began singing a funny song. We love you, Cheryshev. We love you, Cheryshev.
Estas cosas estamos convencidos que nunca más van a volver a pasar, ¿no?
That's probably what the directors of the next club thought. Number 2, Paris Saint-Germain. In 1997, PSG did the same thing as Real Madrid in the Champions League. Paris used Laurent Fournier against Steaua Bucharest, who was suspended at the time. Unsurprisingly, the Romanians made a complaint and won 3-0 via forfeit. Except, during this era, PSG were on the positive end of comebacks. The players were motivated by the challenge they were up against and won the second leg 5-0. An incredible match, which shows nothing is impossible in football. Number 3. Napoli cheated. Nothing is impossible, except for maybe cheating Cristiano Ronaldo's Juventus on a night in October 2020. With the coronavirus pandemic in full swing, Napoli were formally banned by their local prefecture from going to Turin. The risks were too great, especially as Napoli already had two positive cases at the time. Absolute absurd scenes then followed. The nets were set up, the corner flags were in position, the cameras were in place, and the Juventus players were ready to play. Except they clearly had no opposition. As crazy as it seems, the Italian league refused to delay the match and gave the win to Juventus through default. Oh, and we nearly forgot. The Italian league also gave Napoli a point penalty for their behavior. Number 4. Roma self-destructs. Staying in Italy in 2020, AS Roma also had to forfeit a match. But unlike Napoli, the club only had itself to blame. Roma made a big mistake from day one of the league by lining up Amadou Diawara on the pitch. The midfielder wasn't suspended and had played in around 20 games for Roma the previous season. So what was the problem? As it turns out, Diawara was never put on the list of 25 players that could play in Serie A. He'd been able to play in the league games before because he was on the list of players under 23. Except, Roma forgot to change the list when he turned 23. No appeal was made against the verdict. Number 5. Bastia killed by their own fans. In 2017, Bastia were on the verge of ruin. The Corsican club was fighting to stay in League One and had to beat Olympique Lyonnais. Except, before the kickoff had even taken place, things got out of control. During the warm-up, tempers flared between Bastia fans and some Lyon players, including Memphis Depay. Some of the fans saw red and ran onto the pitch to fight. A violent brawl broke out and kickoff was delayed for several minutes. The match finally started, but another fight broke out. The match was definitely stopped and Bastia lost by default. The following season for Bastia? Number 6. Forfeiting the Champions League final. It's without a doubt the craziest match forfeit in history. In May 2019, Wydad Casablanca and Esperance de Tunis faced off in the African Champions League final. An hour into the game, the Moroccans thought they'd equalized and celebrated. This goal was actually the beginning of the end for the Moroccans. The referee didn't give the goal for a non-existent offside and refused to go and look at VAR, on account of him being told that VAR was broken. The Moroccans were furious and decided to leave the pitch as a form of protest. It should be pointed out that during the first leg, extremely suspicious decisions had already been made against them. The match never resumed, and the African Football Confederation gave Esperance de Tunis the title by forfeit 3 months later. Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to leave us a like and please subscribe to the channel. Now, the voice is yours. Give us your ideas for new videos in the comments.